Hello, Algebra 2B, and welcome to another lesson. Here is 6.2. In this lesson, we're going to be looking at how properties of rational exponents are related to those of integer exponents. Let's just do a quick little warm-up activity here, going through breaking down square roots, if you remember how to do those. So things like the square root of 18, the square root of 75, and the, we'll say x equals the fourth root of 10,000, and see if x equals the fourth root of negative 10,000. Okay, hopefully these problems are a little bit of review for you, so they should not take too long. 18, think of that as the square root of 9 times the square root of 2. Square root of 9 is 3. We have 3 roots of 2. Done. 75 you can think of as the square root of 25 times 3. Square root of 25 is 5. Roots of 3. Also done. Fourth root of 10,000. Fourth root of 10,000, you could type that into your calculator. What times itself 10 times? That turns out to be, so it's actually 10,000. If you remember, to the 1/4 in your calculator, it leaves you with 10. So x equals plus or minus 10. Remember, even and even. And lastly, fourth root of negative 10,000. Remember, if you have a negative and an even, this one is not possible. There are no real roots. Okay? So some basic things to remember from there. Now, moving on to some of the newer material for today, we're going to be looking at some properties of rational exponents. Just remember, a to the m times a to the n, if you have the same base and different exponents, you can add the two of those, so m plus n. For example, say you had 7 squared times 7 to the third, that would be the same as 7, whoops, getting ahead of myself, 7 to the 2 plus 3 is the fifth. Okay, so you can just leave that. So today, if you have 2 to the 1/2 times 2 to the 3/5, that is the same as 2, 1/2 plus 3/5. Remember how to add fractions. You have to have the same denominator, 11/10. If you're not sure how to add fractions, just add those in your calculator. And just be careful, so you cannot multiply things that are different bases, or you can't add their exponents. So something like 3 to the 1/3 times 5 to the 2/5, you cannot use that property because the bases are different. Okay, so it does not apply. Similar story, power of a product here, or power of a power, a to the m times n if you have a power raised to another power. For example, 7 squared to the third is the same as 7 2 times 3 to the sixth. 2 to the 1/3 raised to the 3/5 is the same as 2, 1 times 3 is 3, and then 5 times 3 is 15, to the 1/5. So those properties all apply, multiplying and going through there. Some other properties. So let's move down here. Basically, this one here, you would distribute the power, power of a product. So a m b to the m. For example, say you had 7 to the 4th times 3 squared, all raised to the 5th power. Well, in that case, you can just distribute the power, and when you do that, you multiply. So 7 to the 20th times 3 to the 10th. You can't combine these again because they're not the same base. Okay, using our new things here, so 2 to the 1/3 times 5 to the 3/7, if you raise that to the 1/2 and then distribute your power, that would be the same as 2 to the 1/6 times 5 to the 3/14. Okay, and you can leave these like your answers. A to the negative m, all this does is switches if you have a fraction or if you have a regular number, it turns into a fraction. Just notice that the sign goes away once you make the fraction. So I like to think of it as going into the denominator of a fraction. Anyway, so 7 to the negative third is simply 1 over 7 to the third. Another example, 1 over 2 to the negative third actually becomes 2 to the third over 1, essentially. This just moves up due to the negative power. What we can also do is the same thing now with fractional exponents. So 1 over 5 to the 1 fourth, the negative 1 fourth, would just be 5 to the 1 fourth. Okay? So basically all the properties just apply to fractions now. If you have the quotient, you subtract. So same base, you can subtract the powers, m minus n. Key thing is they must have the same base. So 7 to the 5th over 7 to the 3rd, if you do 5 minus 3, that is 7 squared. Example for these ones, 7 to the 1 half all over 7 to the 2 thirds. 1 half minus 2 thirds is 7 to the negative 1 sixth. And then this is where we start to apply our things. That is 1 over 7 to the 1 sixth. It is never appropriate to have a negative exponent in your answer. You then need to write it as a fraction, please. So just be aware of that. And last property, I believe, is a to the m over b to the m. That's what this would become. Just remembering to distribute that exponent to the numerator and to the denominator. So let's say you had 7 over 2, and we raise that to the second power. That would be the same as 7 squared over 2 squared. And again, the same thing is going to apply to fractions and 2 to the 2 thirds. Multiply all that to the 1 third and distribute to both. That is going to be 7 to the 1 sixth all over 2 to the 2 ninths. Okay, so all those properties are still going to apply. Now, let's look at some other more challenging problems. So let's work on simplifying some of these expressions. So just some practice here. Same base, what's that mean? We can add the exponents. So 1 fourth and 1 half is just 7 to the 1 fourth plus 1 half is 7 to the 3 fourths. Done. 6 to the 1 half times 4 to the 1 third, you can distribute the power of 2. You can't combine them because of the different bases. So this is really 6 to the 1 half times 2, and then 4 to the 1 third times 2. So it is 6 times to the first, essentially, times 4 to the 2 thirds. And that's your answer. Last one here for this set is distributing. So this would be 4 to the 5 times negative 1 fifth, and 3 to the 5 times negative 1 fifth. That's going to make it 4 to the negative 1 times 3 to the negative 1. Negative exponents don't mean negative numbers. They just mean that they would be underneath in a fraction. 4 times 3, you can then rewrite it as 1 over 12. Okay, next one here. So if the exponent is not there, it's always a 1. So we're actually going to be subtracting. So 5 to the first minus 1 third is going to be 5 to the 2 thirds. Problem here. So let's see what we can do with this one. With this, we can first, so this is actually a trick. There's a little trick to this problem, okay? First, let's look at it like this here. Let's kind of rewrite it as 42 over 6. And since they each have the 1/3, we can actually kind of undistribute that from both. Okay? And then that's still raised to the second power. Okay? The neat thing with this is you can take 42 and 6 and just divide those to 7. So if you notice that the exponents are the same, you can undistribute it first. Boop, boop. Okay, divide the 7. Then we have that to the 1/3 squared, which, if you would use this property, that's simply 7 to the 2/3 if you multiply those. So a little trick with that one for you there. Okay. With this one, you cannot use that trick because these exponents are not the same. So not trickable with this. Instead, just distribute that power of 4. So 30 to the 4/5 all over 5 to the 8/3. Different bases and everything like that. So this is actually where your final answer is. Okay, distributing the exponent. So 5 to the 2/15 times 7 to the 2/20, which is same as 7 to the 1/10. So you can reduce fractions if you do come across those. Last problems here. Give these one a try. I would go ahead and I'd pause the video here perhaps, try them out, and then see if you get the same answers. Okay, but I will go ahead through them. Same base, you can add the powers. So 2 to the 3/4 plus 1/2 is 2 to the 5/4. This is 1. So 1 minus 1/4 is 3 to the 3/4. Distributing the 3. Okay. 5 to the 3 over 3 is 1 times 7 to the 3/4. And then this one here, we can use our trick. We have the same exponents. So let's use that trick. So let's make it 4 to the 1/2 to the 3rd, which makes it 4 to the 3/2. Okay, and that's it for those. So nice job on those. Give your attempt at some of the classwork problems that follow, and nice job.